you're approaching a dominant 7 chord, and you're using the dominant of the dominant. You're using a 5 of 5 to approach that dominant 7. In doing so, you're going to use a flat 13 or a sharp 5 on the approach note, depending on how you spell it. Let me say something about dominant approach first, though. We've been doing a form of dominant approach all along. For instance, when we have a diminished approach, like this, we call that diminished 2, and we do a diminished, what we're really doing, can you see that that's a form of dominant approach also? Because this, you could analyze this as a C7 flat 9. Every time we do a diminished approach, it's another form of dominant approach. When we make it a diminished chord, here's the melody. We harmonize it with a diminished chord. Well, that diminished chord, I mean, if I spell that C sharp as a D flat, would that be easier to see? It's a C7. It's a C7 flat 9. It's a form of dominant approach. But that's not what we're going to call dominant approach. We're going to keep calling that diminished approach. So the kind of approach that we call dominant approach uses 5-7 of that for the approach note. C7. We're going to, again, use 5-7 of the dominant chord that we're approaching, but we're going to tweak it by substituting flat 13 for 5, or sharp 5 for 5. There's only 2 melodic occurrences where we can do this. Only 2. One is when 13 goes to 5. Right now, if we had 13 going to 5, we'd have bad voice leading because nothing would move. So we know that's not good. The melody moves, nothing else does. 13 going to 5. So this is one of the cases where we want to use dominant approach. What we do is this. We label it DA. I always have to bring up when I say DA. That stood for something when I went to junior high school. It was a hairstyle. Anybody know what the name of the hairstyle was?
Duck's House.
Yeah. Thank you.
Because I like Elvis.
So what we're going to do, this stays the same. Here's what we're going to think. We're thinking dominant of that. Dominant of that dominant 7. By the way, I did 9 for 1 there. Yeah. Dominant, what is the dominant of this?
The dominant of E?
Dominant of that chord. G7.
Not bad by that.
So what we're thinking, this is our thought bubble. We're thinking G7 with a flat 13 or a plus 5. Usually it comes out better to spell it as a flat 13, because you're descending. So this becomes 9, thinking of a G7. This is 7. Here's the flat 13, or sharp 5. But again, it's better to spell it as flat 13. If we spell that as a D sharp, then we'd need a D natural over here. And what are we left? 9, 7, flat 13. 3. And usually it's better to spell the 3 enharmonically. Now, if you don't need to, don't do it. But 9 times out of 10, there's a good reason to do it. And here it is. 3 is a B natural. If we write B natural, then we have to write B flat. So we do C flat. And we get a better way to harmonize that melody. Without the dominant approach, it would be lousy voice fading, no harmonic variety. With dominant approach, and we like that.
Can I get the chunky one again real quick?
Lower voices. Digesting it. Okay, that's one occurrence. One thing, and Robbie, yeah, memorize the occurrences, because this, I mean, you know, after you get out of this class, you don't be looking back through your notes and stuff. Or you won't get to see your notes on that. And that's the key signature. I'll keep that key signature. Chromatic to 13. Now, chromatic to 13 right now is not bad voice leading. It's okay, any chromatic approaches is decent voice leading. But it's even cooler if you do dominant approach, because it's the only approach that gives us contrary motion in the voices. That's rare, and it's nice. So instead of chromatic, here's the melody. Instead of chromatic to 13, we'll call it DA to 13. Here's the thought bubble again. Again, we're thinking of a G7. Everybody sees what we're thinking of, a G7. This becomes flat 9. My spelling is enharmonic, but it's flat 9. 7, flat 13, and 3, again, I'm going to spell it that way, because the voice, it's going to save an accidental. Here's a chromatic to 13. It's all right. Here's the dominant approach. Cooler. Either of these would work if it so happened that last attack was a 5-7 of 1 and you did flat 9. You can do flat 9. Here's the first one again, 13 to 5. Here's the dominant approach. Or put a flat 9 on the last attack. That's fine, if you need it. And here's, again, chromatic to 13, regular. With dominant approach. With dominant approach and using a flat 9 in the last chord. Two instances of it. 13 to 5, chromatic to 13.
Within a dominant chord.
Within a dominant chord.